Today we are going to study about human body and different organs present inside it. Before doing this, let me ask you one question. How many cells are present in our body? Can you guess? Well, actually, our body contains millions of cells. Students, do you know amoeba, bacteria? How many cells do they have in their body? Organisms like amoeba, bacteria have only one cell, that is, they are unicellular. And animals having many cells in their bodies are multicellular. All living organisms exhibit functions like growth, nutrition, respiration, circulation, reproduction, etc. In unicellular organisms, all these functions are done by only one cell. But can you imagine what will happen in multicellular organisms if all cells start performing all functions? For example, heart is involved in many functions like blood circulation, digestion, breathing, or lungs are performing excretion, thinking, etc. There will be a lot of confusion or chaos in the body. Then, how do multicellular organisms carry out various body functions? Think about this. All organisms are made up of cells. Hence, cell is considered as structural and functional unit of living organisms. In unicellular organisms, a single cell performs all the functions. But in multicellular organisms, work is distributed, that is, division of labor. It means cells would perform only those functions which are assigned to them. For example, kidneys will do excretion, lungs will help in breathing, heart will pump the blood, and so on. This forms tissues in our body. So, a group of cells that perform a particular function give rise to tissue. Many tissues form organs. Many organs form organ systems, and inside an organism, there are many organ systems. Let's have a look at this hierarchy. Organism, organ system, organ, tissue, cell. So, if we start from the level of cell and proceed towards organism, complexity increases at each level. In human body, there are four major types of tissues. 1. Epithelium. They form outer and inner covers. 2. Connective tissues. That includes blood, bones, etc. 3. Muscles. 4. Nervous tissues present in brain and spinal cord. These four types of tissues give rise to various organs like brain, heart, lung, kidneys, stomach, intestine, liver, eyes, nose, ears, etc. All these organs constitute different organ systems. For example, kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra contribute excretory system. Heart, blood arteries, and veins are a part of circulatory system. Functions performed by these organs are called life processes. Students, some life processes are voluntary, that is, they would occur only as per our wish. For example, locomotion, etc. On the other hand, some processes are involuntary, like heartbeats, breathing, thinking, etc. These processes occur continuously in our bodies. Even in sleep, processes like brain activities, cell division, secretion of hormones, repair of cells or tissues, heartbeats, breathing are taking place. For all these life processes, body needs a lot of energy. This energy is produced by mitochondria from cells. Hence, mitochondria are called powerhouses or ATP producing factories of cell. This is called cellular respiration. Summary. So, just now we have talked about life processes of organisms. These processes are carried out by various organ systems. In multicellular organisms, there is division of labor that gives rise to different types of tissues, organs, and organ systems. Activity. prepare a list of different organ systems from human body.